the media way of thinking is outdated. We have seen the media, through the rise of GME and AMC, continuously and purposely denouncing the whole movement behind the sudden surge of these stocks. But the models the media uses to measure risk for GME is outdated due to growing number of unknown variables, which can be traced back to the attacks on the World Trade Center. 9/11 changed the way we perceive risk because it replaced chance with purpose, introduced hostile intent to a formula that should only display probability. We can protect ourselves against chance as a variable that implies that something can happen, but we are defenseless against the concept of terrorism. This hostile intent turns every human being into a potential danger, changing our ability to correctly balance and measure our actions. Over the years, the media has done a good job at blocking every type of advancement that did not include the old ways of the systems. They denounced the rise of cryptocurrencies, undermined the electric car markets, and loved to spike up racial tensions for the sake of keeping ratings high. But then came the rise of GME, a society with the growing number of income inequality, now living in their second recessions, with rising political tensions, a cathartic expression of frustration is the most commonsensical effect you can expect. Trading communities have risen, promising the things that the media tell them are impossible. Subreddits like Wall Street embodies perfectly the idea that of malicious intent we talked earlier in the perspective of the media, which is why they go to such lengths to discredit its ever-growing community with dismissive remarks and constantly poke fun at us. The key concept to know is that after 9/11, the idea that everyone represents a fundamental risk became part of the model for risk assessment. Risk is the anticipation of a circumstance that can yield danger. The rise of GME doesn't come from the impact of subreddit communities as most would believe, it actually arises from the anticipation of such growth. It is this anticipation itself that causes the media and Wall Street to fearmonger GME and AMC that is driving the prices up. More dangerous than the actual act of protecting themselves by denouncing the Wall Street Bets community, ironically enough, is the measures taken against the rise of them advocating for more congressional regulation against traders that are eroding the very institutions they are or want to defend. They perceive us trades, normal people, as existential threats to their way of being because 9/11 events changed the way we perceive risk. The more they advocate for control and restriction of this risk, aka normal traders, the more they work against their own ambitions. The very institutions they seek to defend and save are the very institutions they are indirectly helping to bury. Much of the rise of crypto can be attributed to lost faith in the banking system, which disproportionately benefits itself rather than its customers. It illustrates the direct reflection of public sentiment and trust, and has become a hedge against the perceived instability of decentralized currency like the American dollar. The anticipation of financial catastrophe makes media reflectively act on unreliable models that lead to self-defeating consequences. GME is symbolic of a change in society that is forced to explore new ways of dealing with risk as the institutions we once found personal security no longer provide comfort. When we take the rise of GME and trace back its origins, we find that it helps us understand the collective subconscious impact that 9/11 had on our greater society. I want to thank you for sticking with me to the end. I hope this video helped to illustrate a unique perspective on the rise of GME and AMC. Be sure to like the video if you enjoy this type of content and follow for more.